invariably, of course, as you have heard, the research raises a number of questions, and then we have directed that there should be support so that further investigation research should be done. For example, the point that's been raised by Professor Abdul Karim, if you have been infected before and you develop some degree of immunity, are you now vulnerable or liable to a reinfection? No one knows that, and so we will not delve into speculation on that matter. There's no information about it. When the information comes, we'll talk about it. Then the other question that's been raised is about the effectiveness of the vaccines. The vaccines that that are being researched, as far as we know, they are effective in dealing with this issue. And therefore, unless there's a new research that shows that there's a problem, we'll continue with the program of vaccines when the vaccines come next year. So people shouldn't be worried that, okay, why are you continuing with this vaccine because there's now a variant? We'll continue anyway, because firstly, the first COVID is still there, but secondly, we will want to get evidence that there is a problem with the vaccines. And so that is in the hands of the scientists. So before there's any change, there was no new action that we will deal with it as such.